Hello Tribe, welcome back to my channel. Nice to see you all here today. So my setup is different. I have finally moved, still settling, picking up interior details. I don't know if anyone is interested. I might make a video on it if you'd like, before and after settling, because I'm aiming for a little bit more interesting interior, not something that is very usual, like, you know, beige, gray, white. I wanted to bring some color to it. And what was interesting, the rug that I've picked, guys, the rug that I've picked, I sent a video to Joseph Moon, Joey, right? Joseph Moon channel. And he goes, Brigitta, this is your intuitive deck colors. And it didn't hit me. It didn't hit me until he said it to me. And basically, whoever does know my intuitive deck, so this is the color scheme that I do have in the intuitive deck, a bit of gold and a bit of turquoise. But the rug has, instead of turquoise, there is more like blue tones to it. But yeah, if you're interested, once I have done this, I think I still need a month or so for the rest of the furniture to come in. I'm gonna make a video on it, guys, because I feel like that rug is a representation of this aqua channel, hey? So I hope everything is fine with you. Collectively, I must say, things that are happening to people around me and as well as clients, I'd say there is this vibe about people moving in general. It's not only me. People are finding places to settle in, or at least they are making plans when it comes to locations or improving their domestic environment overall. So that's something to pay attention to. There is also a lot of people I've noticed are working on self-improvement too, which I really like seeing. And there are a lot of answers, you know, being given, but not all the answers are going to be shown to you as the Ace of Swords. Some of them, you might feel things coming your way, like I kind of know what it means, but I'm not sure, you know what I mean? Or I kind of know where this is headed, where this is headed towards to, but I'm not sure about the outcome. It's fine, this is saying, you don't need to know every single detail, just take the energy as it comes, okay? So as you see, we have the third wave joining the channel. I think we're gonna have so many more. All right, ready? I'm gonna start with your piles, guys. Now, I really don't know what's the topic of this reading. All I knew is that I wanted to do it. So I guess what we're gonna go with is the topic, what do you need to know? Is there anything that you might need to know? So for some of you, it might be a confirmation. For some others, it might be something that we're not aware of. So in every case, it might be different, okay? All right. So let gravity do the work for pile number one. I might put some objects on top today, unless you already know which number is yours. Now give me a card for pile number two. All right. Pile number three. All right, 1 second. That card showed itself to me, so I have to take it. It flipped. And number four. Number four. There are two cards that want to come out, so we'll have to do it. Okay. All right. All right. So now for pile number one, I want this shell over here. For pile number two, I'm looking at this shell right here. For pile number three, I'm looking at the stone. For pile number four, I want this shell right here. Now I'm going to take the camera out of the holder. And I'm going to show you all of these piles from closer. Sorry about the interruption. So right, what we have here, pile one, two, three, and four. So stop the video if you need some more time to decide, and I'm gonna catch you in timestamps.
Hello tribe, hello pile number one. So I must say there is gonna be a bit of a background noise until I get my table, because right now this is an extended sill, window sill, which is a bit like a table too. So I'm working here for now, but the thing is, this fridge is making noises. If you can hear that in the background, and as I don't have my table just yet, I'm gonna have to go with it. Even though I really love this space, so maybe I'm gonna have to figure something out with the sound. We'll see, guys, we'll see. Bear with me on this journey. All right, so pile number one, what do we have for you? What do you need to know right now? What do you need to know right now? We have the magician, and I felt it in reverse though. So what do you need to know right now is what you are seeking for when it comes to manifestation itself, what you've been working on, and almost like envisioning. For some of you, have a very clear focus. You're like, I know where it is that I need to go. What you need to know right now is there might be some kind of adjustments to the time frame. And it's not going to be, this is not an actual adjustment. It's more so like what kind of time frame you've imagined it to happen. Allow a little bit of flexibility when it comes to getting things done, because it seems like you are very focused on when you want it. But this is saying there is going to be a bit of a adjustment, not by you, but by the source, God, universe, whatever you believe in. So let's see a bit more. For you, I kind of want to use, you know what? Let's take the zombie deck, shall we? I really want the zombie deck for you guys. Okay. Let's see, pile number one, what do you need to know? I also have to mention, I heard it in my head, soul never dies. Why you needed to hear that, maybe one or two of you, especially if you have lost a loved one, this is for you. They're not far away, you can always connect to them. Right? You can always connect to them. Soul never dies. Okay. Energy. Energy doesn't come from nowhere and doesn't go anywhere, right? It's always circling. So that's something that for some of you might be important to know. Now let's let gravity do the work. What is it that you need to know about? We have the Knight of Cups coming through. I'm gonna show you cards in a minute. We have the Three of Wands. Someone is coming your direction, guys. Someone is coming your direction. We have the Knight of Wands. Yeah, with fire. With fire. They're moving fast. Now, this can be physically, or can be over communication over the phone, online. And we have the Queen of Cups, bottom of a deck. We've got the King of Swords. I might say what you need to know as well. This is very strange how this is coming through. Are you worried for some of you about your home environment? Why am I saying that? It's because of these two cards. Three of Wands and the King of Swords in this deck. This guy seems like he's protecting his household. And the same like here. So it does seem like for some of you guys, are you not allowing someone in your home, or do you feel like someone is not invited? This is so strange. I'm hearing someone is not invited. I'm protecting my household. I want to get into this a bit more. Do you need to protect your household? What is going on? See, even here, the Two of Cups, we have two people dining here, well, a person and a zombie in this deck. It seems like maybe you would want to let the person that you feel like you are close with in. Someone needs to let someone in. So it can be metaphorically or it can be actually physically letting someone in. Now, what I felt for one or two of you is the very opposite. So you're gonna have to follow your gut feeling with that here. Don't let just anyone in. This, and I can't say which part of you guys, you know, this is general. You're gonna know where your intuition lies in this message. For some of you, you're being asked to let someone in. For some others of you, be cautious whom you let in your home. And I don't know, maybe it's to do with your with the whole pandemic situation. Or someone is just wanting to change their locks because maybe someone moved out. And maybe there is some kind of an ex situation here. Like, I don't want that Knight of Cups to come towards me. I'm gonna lock my door. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want it. I don't want it. I feel like this reading is gonna trigger some people, but I can't read it other way. And I can't keep information hidden unless whatever I'm seeing, I'm telling you guys here, okay? But at the end of this this journey here, this is a story. At the end of this journey here, what we have is some kind of victory. Are you fighting with someone? Are you like... almost like someone wants to barricade themselves in their own home. Now, for those guys, and this is quite important, for those who are back from some kind of travel, and you know that you need to, this whole pandemic situation, and you know you need to isolate yourself, I'd say that would be a good thing to do because of this Three of Wands. Especially if you know that people are being checked, or you know that by rules, you should be doing that. And I never like to tell people, you know, what to do in such a situation, especially with this topic, because there are so many opinions. But I think this is for your own good. That would be something for your own good. So, giving you an example, like, you know, let's say I've traveled back from a country that has quite high numbers, and I know that I need to isolate myself, but I'm like, oh, you know, screw it. This is someone's birthday that is quite important and no one minds. You know, it's very important for other people not to mind as well. And being cautious of everyone. It's like a tree, right? And then when you make that decision, something actually happens and you're like, oh, I should have stayed home, you know? For example, you get fined or anything in that. Yeah, this is such a strange reading, guys. I didn't even expect it to go that way because I don't really like talking about it, but I do believe that this can be quite helpful for some of you out there when making a decision, because someone really needs to look and kind of protect their home environment from what it is that you don't want at your home. So would it be some kind of germ even, you know? Would it be a person that you don't want to invite, let's say, in your space? And listen to your gut here. What do you need to know? There's gonna be some kind of a resting period after all this story, so I'm gonna leave this behind now. There's gonna be a resting period here where you're gonna be able to take some time off and take care of your body more. And I think that is needed for pile number one. This is needed for you. Do you remember how I talked about this change of time frames or adjusting time, especially when it comes to getting things done? If you're gonna feel like you are in this moment of a bit of stagnancy, or things are not moving according to your schedule that you have made for yourself, This is saying take care of other things then. Take care of your own body, your own peace. What you can do meanwhile. What do you need to know? We have strength. Yeah, for some of you, maybe even your own mental mental health. Restore your mental health, this is saying. Yeah, look at these two cards. We have strength. So what I'm looking at here is the headspace of this person. Now, take a look at the Two of Wands guy here. He's like, oh my God, I don't know what to do, which direction to take. My head is spinning 360, right? So it almost seems like you're gonna be given time of peace, of tranquility, of maybe in some cases you're gonna see it as stagnancy, but that's not going to be a case where you'll need to put your mind to rest a little bit in order to figure out what it is that you want to do next. And take that time. Take that time to plan things for yourself. Yeah, look, what is this hermit doing? She's reading a book while eating chocolate, right? She doesn't care what is happening behind her because she's so in peace. I'm pretty sure those guys are making a lot of sounds. I'm pretty sure that they are, but she's like, they can't get me. I'm chilling. Whatever is outside over there, this is none of my business. All I need to know is that these walls are strong enough with a strength card, right? And I'm gonna mind my own business. A bit like the Queen of Cups here. Look at what she's doing. I would pay attention to your diet for some of you as well. If you wanna maybe eat healthier, that'd be great. Maybe some kind of, I think you might want to switch to organic stuff for some of you, or maybe just the way you used to eat. No more, I'm hearing. See what this Queen of Cups does? She's like, got my whiskey, got my brain, I'm good. A bit similar like the Hermit card here. And again, I'm paying attention to how this Hermit card is shown indoors, where in regular tarot, the guy is with the lantern is wandering around, right? Searching for what it is that makes his soul happy. Now here, it's a lot to do with your household, guys. I must say, make your home your own peaceful temple. Make your home your own peaceful temple. If your intuition says to you that you don't want to, for example, invite someone, or that's a bad idea, listen to your intuition. Especially if someone is coming from some kind of vacation, or they've been going around. This is not to scare anyone here. It's about your own, following your own gut feelings. And regardless of what kind of opinion you have when it comes to germs and when it comes to viruses, right? I'm hearing someone saying it's not only about you, it's about everyone else. So I do believe that maybe some of you have gone through this already, where you had to make a decision when it comes to that. You're like, I'm gonna listen to my gut. And it's funny because when I look at the Three of Wands here and the Hermit here, it seems like these people are breaking in, right? And she's like, chilling, my door is made of steel, you know. She's so in peace. So for a lot of you, this is asking you to find peace in your home. Maybe you're gonna go through that time period where you're gonna be like, okay, I need to adjust something in my household in order for me maybe strengthen that wall, you know what I mean? Take it metaphorically. Maybe change some things around. Maybe you're gonna take a look at Feng Shui for some of you, right? This is all about feeling peaceful in your home, feeling warm, having a good meal. Meals are important here, right? I showed you the Queen of Cups together with the Hermit, and look at the Two of Cups. All of this is important here. So to sum it up, food, then what do you feel like doing when it comes to your household? Improvements, maybe not wanting to go around too much. Maybe having your own sanctuary or altar somewhere would be great for you guys. And take a bit of time off, especially if you're trying to make a decision here. rest a little bit so that decision will come to you quicker and more in a more organic way, where, you know, when your mind is not racing, your intuition is able to speak, right? So I hope that this made sense, pile number one. That was quite an interesting one, and I'm gonna catch you in the next one. Bye for now. Hello, pal two people. So I must say there's gonna be a bit of a background noise because I'm still waiting for my table to come, who does know I've just moved, and I'm recording on, it's an extended windowsill, which is also a table, which I dearly love. But the problem is there is a fridge not too far away, and when it needs to do its work, I can hear it working. So you might hear it go off, but I really need to figure out what to do with this because I really love this space. This is my sanctuary. I do have a beautiful window here overlooking. There's evening sun. I mean, I just really love this. If anyone knows what to do when it comes to refrigerator sounds, tell me. I do have my mic on and it's a bit further away from it, but it's still there, you know, it's still there. I don't know what to do. We'll see, bear with me. So, part two, what do you need to know? Oof, I really love this Eight of Cups, especially in this deck. Whoever needs a name of a deck, I do have a completely different video made on decks only that I use on this channel. It's in the description in every recent video. Now, what I want to say, guys, what you need to know, I don't think that a lot of you see this in a picture just yet. For a lot of you, intuitively, that's what I'm picking up. What you don't know about is that you are leaving for a new venture of some sorts. Now, leaving, it can be physically, it can be emotionally, you can interpret it many ways, but you are leaving for something new here. And you're gonna discover something much better in this journey of yours. Ooh, card on the floor. And I felt it, so we'll take it, if I will be able to pick it up off the floor. We have the Seven of Wands, by the way, this is a zombie deck. Whoa, this is a story. Okay, let me pull more cards, we're gonna talk about this. We have the Magician. Mm-hmm. Now, what you need to know, pal, too, when you feel like you are going to be forced out of a situation, it's not going to be against you, it's going to be done for you. Okay? That's something that I want you to know. And I'm having a bit of headache in pal, too, so I'd say... what would help for pile number two? Have a salt bath. It seems like for some of you have gathered quite a lot of energy that is not yours. So with salt bath, you're going to be able to wash it away. While being in the bath, avoid any tech. Just have maybe your meditation music, if you'd like to, a candle. And just lay there. We have the Hangman. How to brace ourselves. This is a very interesting story. We have the Page of Cups, so let me start talking about these first, and we're gonna pull more cards. We have the Six of Swords in the bottom of the deck, which is an amazing representation of Six of Swords, I must say. I really love this deck. I don't know why I haven't used it as often. Now, why I said you're being forced, if you're gonna be feeling like you're being forced out of a situation, this is happening for your own good. Because the vision that I got the moment I've pulled the Seven of Wands, I put it together with this picture here. These hands are pushing this guy towards something new. But the way it's happening at first, it might feel a bit intimidating. Like, I need to stand my ground. I don't care. I'm gonna be here. I'm gonna do the same thing, you know. Don't touch me kind of thing. But what really is happening What I'm paying attention to here on the magician, these two people, when it comes to face, they somehow similar to me. It gives me a vibe of the same person. Someone who used to be overprotective over their or actions or what they know and they are comfortable with, by allowing themselves to go, right? They're gonna tune into the magician vibe here, which is everything that I think a lot of you are looking for right now as I'm speaking, for things to be moving forward when it comes to getting shit done, as well as opportunities. So what you need to know, by being pushed out of a situation, you're going to be pushed into some kind of period of manifestation. But I always like to say, in manifestation, we meet universe halfway. We're working on what it is that we want to achieve, and we meet in the universe halfway, right? So we add these two energies and we do have something that we wanted to get. I think for a lot of you, what you need to know is that your life is going to be improving and it's going to be a bit of a journey here, like in this department I'm seeing, because I think some of you won't want to let something go. And you're going to be like, nah, I'm used to this. I'm comfortable with that. That's something that I know of. I'm not going there. I don't know where this door is leading me. But really, it's leading you to magician here. For you guys, I don't know why what's coming through here. What you need to know of is to be a little bit less... to accept someone's suggestion. I think one person in particular might say something to you that is going to be quite a bit of a value statement, but at first you might be like, nope, I don't like hearing that, or nope, this is not something that goes with me very well, and you're going to want to fight that opinion off maybe for some of you, right? That's what I'm picking up here. But really, it's taking you good places here. There is some kind of a discovery in this journey that is happening, where I think what you're gonna be proving, pile number two, is that nothing happens for just no reason. And especially when it comes to things that you feel like you've been holding on to for too long. But this is not about that as much. You know how I'm feeling? I'm gonna give you an example. And I think those examples help me to make you feel a certain way. Because sometimes I can't describe what I'm feeling, so I give you examples of situations. Example, I have been using a face cream that has been perfect to my skin for 5 years now. Now someone comes in my life, right? There is conversation happening, and this person says, no, you know what, you should be using this product actually. This is already something old, you need to change formula. Looking at your skin, you know, you could maybe, I know it works for you, but you should try this improved product or something that came out that is newer. And that feels for you very unfamiliar. You're like, nah, I know that product worked for me, that face cream. I'm not changing it. Like, I don't want it. This works for me. I don't need anything else. Why do I need to try something new, right? But by trying that new product out, you don't know what else it can give you, because you haven't allowed yourself to jump into the unknown and to leave that old cream behind. And then you're gonna be like, hey, this is actually stopping the little wrinkles, right? So see what I'm getting at? So that's what kind of situation that what you need to know about. Kind of try and interpret it to your own life, that moment of, actually, that's something good, but first you won't want to do it. Or for some others of you, how you're gonna see that situation of you having to leave something behind, right? You're gonna be like, I know everything happens for a reason, but at this instance, I don't see it, because I was pretty comfy, I was pretty happy with whatever the thing is. And where that leads you, it's going to be a time for contemplation after you're going to start seeing things moving in your life. You're going to be like, whoa, and this has happened, and this cream has done this and that for me. See that laboratory? I'm just going to go with that story. And you know what? It stopped actually the aging process much quicker for me. I'm seeing a difference in already a month, you know, using it. Maybe the skin tone even changed. And you will want to explore from then on. You will want to explore the unknown. The way you are comfortable with something in your life, but once this situation happens, you're gonna be much more open to new things in your life. Whatever that would be, with the Page of Cups here. I wanna build different castles and I wanna build more of them, right? For me, when I think of pages are very curious, almost like kids to me. So almost like bringing your inner child out a little bit, leaving that maybe overly structured thinking or overly structured plan or goal of some sort. It's good to have goals, don't get me wrong here, but when it comes to multi-managing the universe almost, right? That's when it can be, you can put yourself a little bit in a restrictive mode. And I think for a lot of you, by going through this journey of a cream situation, what you're gonna realize that there is so much more out there that you haven't discovered just yet. And then you're gonna be walking towards that door, and not only one, but there's gonna be many more afterwards, and you will be feeling that you are very happy to explore the new, I'm hearing newness to your life. Whoa, pile two, it's very interesting. What do you need to know about pile two? What do you need to know about? We have the Ten of Cups here. Here we hold. I said that once before. What is wrong with me? I think I said it once in one of the other picker cards. Here we ho, so I guess this is gonna be my saying. Here we ho, Ten of Cups, your happiness is coming through here. And I really love this. This is for me, when I look at this card, look at the Page of Cups, he's at the beach and these guys are at the beach. A very particular scenario for one of you, probably maybe two out there. If you are looking for reconnection with your child, this is happening. I almost feel like someone is bringing someone back to the family. So it doesn't only have to be children. Being reconnected with family. Because when I look at the Page of Cups here, in this situation, it seems like this guy is on his own. Here it does seem like his mama have been looking for him, and looking at the sky, maybe this guy was on the other side over there, because the sky is quite gray in the Page of Cups, and now she's got him and she's like, hey, family time again. You know where I'm getting at here? Some kind of closer connection happening in your own family here. What was it that you were lacking, even if it's not an actual person? Where their feelings lacking was, what was lacking, this is saying, is going to be fulfilled. What do you need to know? We have the Devil. Oh, this is already a different story. Okay, give me more. Tell me, what is that about? Together with lovers. There is going to be someone very tempting for you, pile number two. There's going to be someone very tempting and very mysterious for you. For some of you, might be making a decision between two people, and you're going to be feeling quite torn, because maybe with one person you are going to be feeling this very intense sexual chemistry, and then you're like, I don't know what to do, but this other person has all the you know, we have very similar traits, maybe interests, and but I can't keep my hands off this other person. There is going to be a decision that you're making overall. Let's not be overly specific in general here, but overall you're going to be making a decision about a person. And it does seem like you might get an answer through a dream here. So please pay attention to that. Now, example. Example, if you're just thinking about a certain person and you feel maybe intuitively that this is someone who's not entirely good for me, there is something about this person that gives me a maybe an off vibe, or I know that this is not something that is going to be long term, but I'm looking for long term, right? Pay attention to your dreams. In a dream, there's going to be a representation or of the person. Now, this person doesn't have to come through physically the same in a dream, but you're going to know that this is a person, right? Some kind of maybe romantic situation might be going on. If that is a romantic situation that you're dealing with, there's going to be that representation of a situation. And you're going to, what to pay attention to and how to know what you're being told what to do is to pay attention how you felt in that dream. Did you feel happy in that situation? Did you feel like there is something off for you about it? Did you feel like there is something you still don't know and it doesn't make you feel great about it? So the feeling is going to be your answer, okay? The feeling is going to be your answer. Okay, I think that's pretty much it for pile number... Sorry, someone needs to know that your child is protected. I have to put it out there. This came through. You need to know that your child is protected, or the younger one, okay? Whatever this represents to you here. And Tribe, thank you very much for coming back. Love you as always. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now. Hello, pal number three. So if you skip the intro, I don't know if I mentioned that in the intro. I don't think so. No, I didn't. So as you know, I have moved, but now what you're gonna be able to hear is that annoying noise in the background. What is a shame is that I do have an amazing workspace here. This is an extended windowsill with a beautiful view and evening sun. It's gone. Yes, it's gone for pile three. Amazing. But what is happening is that there is a fridge not too far away from here. So I love this working space, but that fridge, when it's working, it has that buzzing sound. And I do have my mic farther away from me, but you can still hear it. So I don't know if I'm gonna have to time this reading somehow according to that damn fridge, or if some of you know, because I don't want to leave this space, honestly. Like, I'm waiting for a table in the living room, but I really love this vibe here, apart from the fridge. If you know what to do in order for that fridge to work a bit more silently, let me know. But I think I'm gonna have to look for, I don't think a new mic will help. Any suggestions, drop it down below, guys. We're gonna have to figure this out together. But yeah, and I'm gonna, I think, be looking at the timing, how often it starts working and making that sound. So let's get into your reading. What do you need to know, pile three? Oh, this is nice. This is very, very nice. See, what you need to know is that where you're gonna be around 3 years from now is not something that you can imagine of right now, and it's perfectly normal. But I think you're gonna be much more achieved in a sense than you can imagine right now. So there is a lot of warmth, there is a lot of success coming through here, and also respect as well as recognition. And what you need to know right now, you don't need to force and you don't need to rush towards that goal of some sorts, right? Whatever that success is for you here, what you need to do, what this horse is doing there, how I'm seeing this card, there are a lot of things, there is a journey here that this horse has to go through in order to get to the top of a mountain. And all of those, I almost see it as a track, you know, with obstacles that train this horse to get to the top of a mountain. Now, don't take those obstacles as bad things. These actually help this horse practice and strengthen its muscles. And it's gonna be experiences that are gonna take you towards that mountain. And that track, the way it's paved for me in my own vision here, okay, it's very diverse, but it's also very fun if you make it to be. So it depends how you're gonna look at the situation. Will you look at this success and achievement as a long journey and you're gonna be just aiming for that top of a mountain, or are you gonna enjoy the journey? Because the journey is longer and a journey is our life. So you have to almost like to change your perspective sometimes when it comes to those little obstacles, right? Because that is something that is happening for you, not to you here, in order to get to the top. So kind of enjoy every little thing that is happening and almost like soak every experience in, because you're gonna need that while climbing up that ladder, I wanted to say, that mountain. Okay, I'm using the zombie deck today. Okay, what does pile number three need to know? What does pile number three need to know? And let's let Ryan to do the work. We have the Wheel of Fortune, which is completely with the vibe of this reading. Yeah, some of you need to know that the decisions that you will be making along the journey are not the decisions that are going to, like, don't be afraid to make decisions. You know, for example, someone who needs to make up their mind which way to go, what you already imagine is that if you don't make a right decision, you're gonna go towards a path that is not yours. Now, I don't tend to see things that way. I think every path has its own experiences, and there is no wrong or right way, really. It's about what you need to explore and what you need to find in a specific path along the way there. So for some of you, I think you're a bit afraid of making choices because you do have this maybe mindset sometimes that you need to remind yourself of not to do, is that no choice is a bad choice, really. It's the choice that you needed to make at that time. And what I'm looking at, this Wheel of Fortune, this female here, she hasn't gotten hit. She's very with it. She's like, hey, entertainment, right? I know this knife is not gonna touch me. Spin me whichever way, I know it's still not gonna touch me next time they throw it at me, because I trust the journey. I mean, this is quite a dramatic way of explaining things, right? But that's something that I'm seeing here for you guys. Don't be afraid of certain directions. What does pile three need to know? We have the Hermit. You have made all three major cards here. We have the Chariot, Wheel of Fortune, as well as Hermit. We have the second Chariot here, guys. Ooh, ooh. All right, all right. Okay. As well as the Seven of Hazards. Okay, one more, one more. And we have the Devil. I have to clarify this Devil. Oof, the High Priestess here. Look at this High Priestess in this deck. I would want it framed on the wall, honestly. I might paint that, actually. That would be a cool image. Okay. Whew, pile number three. Someone needs to know that they are untouchable, and it's coming through in a couple of cards here. You need to know that you are untouchable. What you need to, and I think it's coming through with the devil as well as the high priestess. Maybe some of you are thinking that maybe there is some kind of energy that is not good for you when it comes to the spirit realm, you know? Or maybe you've been terrified by something. You know, I'd give you an example. Someone who is afraid of the dead, you know? I always say, you know, be afraid of the living, not the dead, because especially our beloved deceased people, they are there to help us not to do anything harmful. Now, there are different entities, obviously. If you feel like there is something that is interrupting you in your day-to-day life, you can go ahead and maybe do some kind of cleansing, do your own ritual, whatever feels right for you. I don't like telling people how to do things. It's a bit like, you know, everyone has to have their own recipe according to their own energy. That's how I tend to see it, you know? And you're gonna feel what's right for you to do and what's not working or not sitting with you right, if you Google that, for example. But overall, what is happening here, I do believe that for pile number three, what you don't know is that you are stronger than any energy that is around you. And I think there needs to be a change of a mindset here. You are stronger than any energy around you because you're the high priestess. You're the high priestess. You're sitting tall on your own spiritual experiences here, right? You know, you're close with your ancestors. And those who are maybe feeling that you are drained or anything along those lines. Now, if this is not your message, leave it for other people, because if this is your story, you already know about it. So it's not for me to push this message onto you, and I don't want you to imagine things that are not really there. But look at this high priestess. This is you. You're sitting literally like, you know, I know what I'm doing. I'm communicating with source, with my ancestors, you know, try me. Now, in the devil card, what you can see is like a shadow person creeping behind here, you know, but they're not doing anything. They're just creeping behind, really. What you need to know is that you are much more powerful, and it can be a representation of a person. Maybe a person whose energy is not good for you, and you're like, oh, you know what? Like, I don't know how to distance myself from them. Yes, you know, you're the high priestess. You know everything here. Now, let's get back to this. So leaving these stories here, this is gonna be, you know, a specific story in this pile for a specific group of people. So please skip the ones that are not yours. Now, what is happening here? Well, you need to know, pile number three, that if there is some kind of a waiting game around travel plans, things are being woven still behind the scenes for you, and you may have to be a little bit patient when it comes to that. Because if you wanted to go ahead and maybe do what you wanted when it comes to movement overall, it doesn't have to be an actual travel, you know, when it comes to movement, if you wanted to push that, you'd probably have to deal with not a very smooth ride, this is saying. So be patient with it. Take notes, know what it is that you need to have prior to some kind of travel plans. Specifically in this chariot, I just see it as a travel card. In this chariot, there was a bit of a different journey, right? But this is saying you're gonna get to that location, to that place where you're headed. Right now is the planning stage for you. Because if you departed now, you know, the ride is not the smoothest here, as you can see. So wait for the road to be clear, this is saying. And I think for a lot of you, you are being shown that already. Maybe things are not moving as fast as you want. Maybe there is some kind of, you know, restriction happening. Whatever that would be, this is saying, right now is the time for you to... I almost hear for some of you to adjust your plan. I'm gonna pull one more card for pile number three. One more card in between the chariot and the seven of presents. Yeah. Now is the time. The four of cups in this deck is very... every time I see this, look at her face. I laugh so much. Okay, I used to show a face like that during my study years to my best friend when I was fed up in architecture. All right, back. I'm back. What this is saying, it does seem like if there's gonna be travel plans that are delayed or you're gonna have to decide or adjust your plan somehow, amend something, it's saying that time might be given to you in order to become a bit closer to certain people around you. Become a bit closer with certain people around you who are with you right here, right now. Because it does seem like before you leave on some kind of venture, there needs to be some kind of deepening of connections happening here, but with particularly with one person. Particularly with one person. Look, see what I mean here? It's all about the journey that you're going to be taking. You have to say, almost like cherish this person who's around you right now, because when you will be on this venture of yours towards success, right? You're gonna be pretty busy. So you will want more time with that person. And now, if you feel like there is, stagnancy and this person is around you, enjoy time with them, with the Four of Cups, until the time when you have to go. Okay? So for some of you, this is sweet. This is very sweet. It's saying appreciate the one who is around you now, because you're gonna be very, very busy in the future. I want to clarify the main chariot card. Is there any other story that is that card was come up that is coming through here? We have the world. Yeah, I mean you're gonna be venturing off to the world. I think for a lot of you now, what is happening? You're gonna be quite visible either online or you're gonna be quite known internationally somehow. People see you. People see you. And it almost seems like a preparation for you before you're coming out there to the world. And I think for a lot of you right now is a bit of a resting time. And if you're not in that resting time just yet, recognize when that resting time appears and use it for your own good. Okay, so I hope that this made sense, pile number three. Try. Thank you for coming back. Love you as always. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now. Hello tribe, whoever has picked pile number four. So as you've seen in the intro, you guys, the only pile who got two cards. So let's take a look at what is up. What do you need to know? Ooh, that's why. That is why. We have the Judgment and the King of Cups. So right now, if you feel like you don't know what the heck is going on, and if you've been feeling energetically all over the place, it's because you're going through a massive energetic shift. And things might be feeling very uncertain, but at the end of this journey, you're gonna come out much wiser, I must tell you. But this is on a spiritual level. Look at this guy here. We have a third eye. As well as the Judgment, for me, this is a very spiritual card. It's about something that you don't see physically happening, but it's there in a way. Now, what I'm paying attention to here, what you need to know is that sometimes some of the fears that you might be feeling are not from this lifetime. So maybe some of you were interested in past life regression, maybe some of you even hypnosis. But why I'm saying that, because the bear is usually a really good swimmer, and in this case this guy is freaking out, and there is no base of why is this guy fearful. He's a really really good swimmer, but it does seem like there is some kind of fears coming up to be probably dealt with for you, and I'd pay attention to that. That are not coming only from the maybe traumas from this lifetime, but it might be from the past too. And I think for a lot of you, what you will be going through is this almost like getting to know yourself and your journey, not only in this lifetime, but in the past much more. And after this transition, once you're gonna come out on the other side of it, you're going to be much more aware of why certain things are happening the way they are, why certain people are acting the way they are, why you act in a certain way. And you're gonna be able to recognize almost like you're, you know, like you step back from yourself and you look at everything in 360. So this is quite intense, but it's very exciting at the same time. I wouldn't be surprised if you did experience a lot of, I wanna say, interruptions happening when it comes to your tech too around that time. So I'm gonna be using a zombie deck today. I've been drawn to it. Let's see what pile number 4 needs to know. What does pile number 4 need to know? I want to take the top card and we're going to allow the gravity to do its work. So the first card that we have is the 4 of hazards. Then we have the sun, yeah, seeing clarity. All right. Then we have strength. Majors are coming out. 1 or 9 might be important numbers, as well as 11. We have the 9 of cups, bottom of a deck. We have the 6 of hazards. And for me here, I just love this deck, guys. I just love the representations of this deck. For some of you, what you will be going through too, let's take this card. A shift in your, I want to say, eating patterns. So maybe you're going to be eating more often, but in less quantities than before, or overall your diet is going to be changing, but you're going to be drawn to it. It's not about you taking this message now and saying, I must eat that way. Listen to your body at all times, okay? Now, what I'm paying attention to here in the 4 of hazards, this guy seems like he doesn't want to hear something, you know? He has his ears closed. He's like, no, don't want to hear about it. So if you did have maybe advice from someone who, maybe a professional even, or you know, deep down that you have to change some things up, especially when it comes to shopping, would it be food, would it be anything really, pay attention to those soul urges, you know, or that intuition of yours, what you're being told. Because it seems like for some of you, haven't been eating really well or nutritious food. It was something to soothe you. And what you need to know is that there might be a, the moment you change this around is when you're gonna start seeing clearer. And this is interesting, I said start seeing, and I remembered of the King of Cups in this deck. And this is someone who's very intuitive, right? By the way, there is gonna be also a relationship change with potentially masculine, who is quite in touch with his emotions here. But somehow, I'm just gonna go with it because I'm sensing it. Somehow, what you put in your body and even what kind of activities you are doing, it's changing the way you see things in your life. And especially if you need clarity, maybe some of the habits have been clouding your judgment here. Right? Have been clouding your judgment. Now, do you remember how I said to you that you're going to be able to step out of yourself and see everything, what you are doing, what other people are doing? So for me, when I saw the sun card, that is literally a representation of that. I do believe it's there's what you need to know about that. There's going to be someone coming through, possibly a water sign, or someone who has water sign traits. It doesn't have to be that way. Who is going to put your mind to rest and show you that clarity. there is a person who's quite intuitive. Maybe you're going to be booking a meeting with someone. Maybe you're going to be asking for advice. Maybe the person will just come at the right time in the right place and give you the clarity that you have been seeking for. If you're looking for someone or something, you're going to find it. This is a very specific message for some of you out there. Now, what's happening in the future for you, you are really good when it comes to going with the flow. Where before, maybe you were a little bit resistant, or you were maybe even blaming yourself for certain things. Why am I feeling such way? Why is it happening? And the more you resist it, the shittier you feel. Now, in the future, what you're doing, you're like, okay, there is a massive wave behind me. Even if I'm afraid of water, I'm just gonna ride the wave. Right? I'm just gonna have fun with it. And you take things easy in the future. See, your energy changes from, it's like a day and night here for me. Where before, this guy didn't want to hear what either his body was telling him or what maybe some other people were suggesting or intuition was telling him. But overall, in the long run, this guy is like, tell me everything. I'm gonna take it with a grain of salt, but I wanna listen. It's something about wanting to listen. Maybe for some of you, this is to do with your own maybe child. The dynamics is going to change, especially if you do have issues with them now and they don't listen, okay? What does pile number four need to know? What does pile number four need to know? We have two King of Cups as well as the Knight of Cups. The water energy is quite important here. There is someone who is very caring around you. And I think you don't recognize it just yet. For some of you, don't know this person just yet. What is this person bringing, please? We have the Queen of Hazards. So for me, some kind of, how it feels like to me, some kind of peace of mind when it comes to your foundation. This person is bringing you some kind of peace of mind when it comes to either your family, your home, your foundation itself. And we have the Hierophant. Yeah, you're encountering some kind of a mentor. For some of you, this is your own partner. There is a bit of a hidden information here that was hidden from you before that will come towards you. If you're looking for an answer about one particular situation, it's going to be shown to you. Keep your eyes open, this saying. Now, because I put the Hierophant on top of a Strength card, and in this card we have a bullet next to the brain, it's saying don't allow the media to impact you in a negative way. I'm hearing maybe some of you would say that there's a lot of bullshit on the media or on the news, and I'm not impacted by it. Okay, give me a bit more about the situation. What is this person bringing? Yeah, some kind of an idea, a new beginning, a potential passionate start for something to take form, I'm hearing. I wouldn't be surprised if you would be receiving even some kind of a gift here. Someone is handing something to you in order for you to find what it is that you're looking for. And we have the Two of Cups. This person is quite close. It's gonna be a very close soul connection here. Now, there is a lot of stories here. I don't even know how to put it into one. I'm just going to talk about bits and pieces that I'm getting. You're getting some kind of proposal here for some of you to connect with a person. And I wouldn't be surprised if some of you would be asked to spend some time with them. And that time is going to feel very tranquil, very peaceful, very nice, and very warm. You're gonna feel like home. And it's up to you if you're gonna take that opportunity or not. It depends, obviously, right? Whom this is coming through. But I'd say there is some kind of a love offer coming through here. Oof, we have the Seven of Hazards as well. But almost like this is saying, take one step at a time. Allow this to grow naturally, right? Take notes. Take notes in this journey. Take notes, but for some of you, I must say, do not be very closed off. Some of you are very closed off. You're like, I don't know what to do. I better don't do anything about it, right? Because my head's spinning 360 here. So that is why you need to take, once you're going to get that offer or proposal of some sort, take some time to think about it if you want in your own headspace before making a decision what it is that you want to do, which way to go about it. One more card, pile number four. We have the Four of Wands. It's something to do with indoors here, and it's something to do with home environment. I do believe that, do you remember how I said I wouldn't be surprised if you would be getting some kind of a gift? Maybe happy birthday for some of you out there. You might be getting a parcel for some of you too. That is going to be unexpected. A very nice gesture overall, I must say. Those who are not in restriction when you're watching this video or it's over, I would say that if you're organizing some kind of get-together or party, it's going to be more intense than you have planned. And I think it's going to be, I almost want to say, it's like the good old days. That's something that you would want to say after this party, you know. Everyone was careless. We had an amazing time. If you're doing it at home, be prepared for some spillage, you know, some things happening. Not feeling anything major like door falling out over here. But a lot of people are having fun. And, you know, what I'm looking at here, whosoever birthday or celebration this is, or maybe even wedding in some cases, congratulations if that's the case. This person's having so much fun that they haven't even unpacked the gifts, you know. And it depends, you know, some people don't like to unpack it in front of others. And some people like to see the reactions of people unpacking their gifts that they have given, you know. But how I'm picking this up is that everyone's having so much fun that it's not even about gifts anymore. You know, I don't have time for that. Let's just enjoy. So celebration overall is coming through here. I do believe with the Hierophant now and the Four of Wands that there might be some kind of a engagement or wedding happening. And I think it's going to be grand, pile number four. So that's what I have tried for you, pile number four. Thank you for coming back. Love you as always. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now.